When we are angry, we utter some words. Does these words become real? Dalitya Sahasranamam is the authority for that. Danstrojvala Akshamanaditara Rudirisam Siddha Karadikshakarantam Atruga Varnarubani Lalita Ambika Enava Vaksvarubani Lalita Ambika Enava. Everything, first of all, you start your upasana, Srividya upasana particularly, with a feeling that you are not the doer. You are not the one who speaks. You are not the one who thinks, right? So having said that, all the shapas which the rishis are giving, the rishi was being used as a channel to transmit the karma to the other jiva. So the jiva has to get some karma because he has already done some action. How does he get? A rishi comes and he does something to instigate that rishi, and he curses. It's all an internet and it happens. But we are not seeing the same kind of immediate reaction when we curse somebody. If you say you become a dog, he won't become a dog. He'll still be a human being. But then the same words, if the rishi says, the next moment we see in the movies, a small dog will be there, repenting for the mistakes. Why then? Rishi's words are becoming real and our words are not becoming real because they don't have backlog of karma. They don't have past karmas. So whatever they say, it acts immediately. But we have past karma. So whatever we say also will be real, but not immediately down the road. Maybe next couple of years, or maybe next birth also. That's why I've been telling the parents, particularly mother, father, mother. Mother has more power than the father. Please, in the name of controlling your child, don't say harsh words. If you don't do your homework, you'll never get a seat in the college. Period. That boy will struggle to get a seat in the college. Every word, aham brahmasmi, is the reality. Every word we utter will become reality. That's truth. But having said that, getting anger, and the anger, at higher level is hatred. And in that hatred, you curse somebody, you hurt somebody with strong words. It's going to be real. It's going to happen. But at the same time, because you hurt that person with your curse, you have to pay the penalty sometime down the road. One more person will be waiting for you to curse. So always control our speech. That's right. Parapashyanti madhyama vaikiri rupa bhaktamana sahansika. She gives four stages to control your speech. When you get anger, before you utter your word, just say, I am Vadavada Vagvadini Svaha in your mind, and then utter. See the beauty. Anger, words, whatever words you say, they'll be controlled. Because you're getting connected to para. Pashyanti Madhyama Vaikrupa at your mundane level. Para is before you. So, when you get that angry mood, you need to be watchful, awareness, jagarana, they say. Jagarana is not, we did the jagarana the other day, Chandragana. Everybody, including me, was dozing off, unable to control the sleep. That's not jagarana. When you are in the conscious state, be aware of you. Not aware of the world. world can take care of by itself. You don't need to take care of the world, but take care of yourself. Even that also you don't need to take care, but what if you can't keep quiet. So instead of doing something for the world, I mean on the world, you focus on you. So somebody is yelling at you, immediately focus on you. You are getting anger. Oh my God, it's not good for me. Immediately what you say? Immediately what you are saying? That's all. You give that control to her. Trust me, your words will be sattvic. And you're protected from doing harm to the other person by your utterance. Because aham brahmasmi, ayam atma brahma, tattvamasi, prajnanam brahma. The Chatur Mahavikas, aham brahmasmi is the first one. You're a Brahman. So whatever you say, and that too, the curse acts more, faster than the blessing. It doesn't need. To demolish a house, it's very quick. We just get a book line and remove it. To construct a house, so to hurt somebody is easy. To help somebody is difficult. So having said that, most of the words we tell in anger will become reality. Whether it's said by a upasaka, upasaka means quickly they may be real. Normal people. But at the same time, if the normal person also, out of great pain and anger, pain particularly, tells something that may act faster than the upasaka's words. That's why they say, kalakanta kannirolakina. If your wife sheds tears because of your harsh words, trust me, that's going to affect the generations. She doesn't need to speak. Now you are asking, angry words will become real. For female, particularly role of wife, she sheds one tear out of pain from the husband, the generations will be affected. If she utters a word, there is no future. That much power the female were given. But having said that, they have fixed the qualities of the female also. If you have that quality, then you are a female. Otherwise, a normal entity like a man. So, in a nutshell, whatever we speak is going to happen, whether anger or any feeling. Because amatir medha, for me that is the amatir medha means before that words are delivered, she is the one who makes you speak. Naturally, it has to happen. So that's why in Puranas also, some great people utter some word. Afterward, oh my God, it's going to happen. It came out of me. So that's why better they say not to talk bad things. I should follow that.